Good evening, YouTube. Welcome back to the kitchen. I do need to clean a little bit, so don't judge me. I am prepping a, what is this? Boneless pork loin roast. Because I'm going to smoke this tomorrow and try to make some pulled pork out of it. I've never smoked pork anything before, and I think I've only smoked three things total in my life, so I did not buy any kind of expensive cut of meat because I'm still learning, and just in case it goes horribly wrong, it's not a waste of money. Anyway, we're going to do this following a recipe from Meat Church, which is basically Mexican pulled pork, as they're calling it. So we're going to set that up right now. So we'll start just by opening this pork roast up. So we're going to use some Cholula hot sauce as our binder. I am not a hot sauce guy. Well, I guess I am a hot sauce guy, but I don't typically buy hot sauce. I just order things that are spicy, and I get I have some habanero pepper sauce here that I got in Mexico while I'm on vacation. So we're just gonna lather this up with the Cholula. Cook it fat cap up, so we'll do this side first. Okay. And the Meat Church guys have their own brand of fajita seasoning, but I'm just using fajita seasoning here. So I don't really like the idea of it just in there, not actually stabbed into muscle fiber, so I'm going to go just a tiny bit above it, to where it's actually, I think I'll just go a little diagonal so it stabs through both, top and bottom. There we go. Well, that should do it. Okay, I'm going to foil tent this and put it in the fridge and it'll rest overnight. So I can smoke it in the morning. There we go. Just so it's not touching the actual meat. Put a temp probe up there. Get her in the fridge, and like I said, I'll probably wake up really early, come up, take it out, let it start to get a little bit up to temperature, a little more than the refrigerator temperature, and then we'll get it on the smoker early tomorrow morning and let her go.
Good morning. It's 5:25 in the morning. It's very early. So, just for comparison's sake, the meat is currently at 38 degrees. Definitely, wow, the bottom of that refrigerator gets incredibly cold. So, anyway. Now we're going to let it sit here on the counter. I'm shooting for about 9 a.m. to start smoking. And then about an 8 hour to 9 hour smoke. So, It'll be a good day, but I'm gonna go back to bed.
It's time for both the unveiling of the roast and then it's time to put it on the smoker. I just checked the meat's temperature. It's around 62 degrees. So I'm gonna go ahead and take our foil off here. Look at that beautiful roast. I'm just gonna carry the whole thing outside and put it in the smoker. So there she is. And I like to do the three-quarter rack, because as you see, the top's always hotter than the bottom, so this is kind of a middle, you know, range there. So, button it up. There we got a meat temperature of 62 degrees, bottom, top, and we're going to let it go. See how long it takes to get to, we're gonna treat it similar to a brisket, I think. So at about 165, 170, it's gonna come out. I'm gonna put it in the pan that's the actual drip pan right now, and then give a little more seasoning. I'm gonna put a little chicken stock in the bottom, and it's gonna kind of braise the rest of the way up, and then get foil wrapped and everything. And then it'll come up to like 205, and then it should be ready to rest, and then we'll pull it and hope it makes some great tacos. All right, guys, it's been 45 minutes, so I'm gonna go ahead and spritz it. People say use apple cider vinegar or apple juice. I'm using Angry Orchard, the adult version of apple juice. We got an internal temperature so far of 102, and smoker itself 192 and 182. Quick spritz. She's looking great. It's been another 45 minutes. Spritzed it again. Looking good so far. We're at 114. This was maintaining about 200 degrees until I opened it a few seconds ago. But anyway, so the smoke has stopped because the internal smoke tray ran out of fuel. Now, my last week when I did my smoke, I used my cold smoke box, or Masterbuilt calls it a slow smoker box. But the many hours of sustained heat fried it, essentially. So I tried changing the switch out this week. It just blew another switch. It would never work again. However, because I'm ingenuitive, I've decided it should still function exactly the same if I just light a fire under it. Because that's all the little heating element does, is catch everything on fire. And I've even looked in here before and seen a fire at the bottom. So I know that works. So I've got it full with my wood. And all I'm going to do is I'm going to take the ashtray at the bottom, light this up, put it in there, and then it, in turn, should spread that up to the chimney, and it should burn just like it normally does until it runs out of fuel. So we're going to light that up now and see what happens. All right, well, so far that's working. Smoke's pouring out of here. I've got a decent little fire going in there, so we'll just keep an eye on it. Well, unfortunately, I forgot to film when I pulled it out and wrapped it up. I pulled it out at 167, I think I pulled it out. Put it in the drip pan. About a half a cup of chicken broth went in the bottom. Some more Cholula went on top, along with some more seasoning. And then about a half a
half a stick of butter cut up in cubes, and then obviously wrapped in foil. I'm stuck back in there now. We're at 180 on our way up to about, they say 195 is good, but I've also read people talk about going to 205 and 210 for pulled pork, so we'll keep an eye on it. My chimney worked out pretty well. I had to deal with it a few times today to get the chips to fall and get it to relight, but for the most part it did well. I am not a fan of all this gook or whatever that basically comes up in the condensation from that stuff burning and then drips down everywhere. It actually splashed on the wall over here, unfortunately, and it stained the patio from last week, so that's why I got the piece of cardboard under it this time. So might just stick with using the internal smoke option instead of that box. Anyway, I will update everybody once it comes back, or I'm sorry, once it comes out, and then it rests, and then I pull it and see how it turns out. And the painting project is in full swing. That will be another video, most likely. You can check that out and in its progress. All right. It's been a couple, another hour or so. And we are at 204 degrees. So I think I'm gonna go ahead and take it out. Let's go ahead and kill this guy. Yep. Look at that, 204. Perfect. So, crack her open. Alright, let's get it inside and I'll get it wrapped up. This has been out of the smoker now for probably a little bit over an hour. So, we're going to open her up and see how she looks and see if it pulls. Remember, this is not a butt, not a shoulder. This was a loin roast, so tougher and drier than what you would normally make pulled pork with. It looks amazing. Need to get a fork. Note to self, I gotta buy a meat fork, or a carving fork. I don't own one. I guess technically I need two forks if I'm gonna try to pull this. Get it out of that pool of liquid though, so I can. I want to save all that juice. Cutting board here. First, we'll see if it'll cut at all. It definitely cut. Looks totally done. It is not going to be pull apart. Kind of tender, though. Unfortunately. So, it looks like it's just smoked pork loin. Some of this juice here. Yeah, not all things turn out. So I guess it's not going to be pulled pork for tacos. It's going to just be smoked pork loin. Wow. That is phenomenal. Good spice from the hot sauce that was used as a binder. It is a little on the dry side, which is kind of to be expected. But it's definitely fork tender to be able to cut it up here. Oops. See? Definitely fork tender. Yep, that is delicious. Let me try some sauce. Because now we might as well make it Mexican barbecue pork. Since my pulled pork method didn't work out. Get a piece here, a little bit of stubs on it. Good thing about another jar of this, I'm almost out. There we go. So there we go. Some stubs. Oh yeah. Wow. The pork. The fajita seasoning on there and the Cholula base and the stubs all play so great together. That's sweet and spicy. Well, like I said, it didn't turn out the Mexican pulled pork that I wanted to emulate from Meat Church, but still, it is a delicious pork roast. I'm going to end up cutting it up and probably use it for sandwiches or just as an entree for something to eat this week. So it'll keep me fed all week and it's delicious. So anyway, hope you guys enjoyed it. And I think next time we'll actually try the recommended cut of meat to do this with. Now that I know I got the process nailed down, this took only 8 hours and then it rested for like an hour. So there was no crazy delays like our brisket experience last weekend. So I'm very happy with this. So anyway, hope you guys enjoyed it and join me on the next one. All right, I know that was the end of the video, but I just wanted to give a recap. I did end up slicing it up. And then after following some advice online, I ended up throwing it in the crock pot on the next morning with all the leftover juice. And then after about 9 hours or so in the crock pot, it just shredded apart and it turned into the most delicious pork ever. So I ended up using it all week on tostadas and tacos, and it was some of the best pork I'd ever had.